Billy Nungesser is a familiar face in this tragedy. Of course, he's the president of Plaquemines Parish, where we are here in Venice. And Billy, tell me, first of all, what is your reaction to the fact that these internal documents show, in a worst-case scenario, 100,000 barrels a day, 4.2 million gallons. BP is now sort of saying that's not really true, these numbers aren't accurate, that's not going to happen, they're irrelevant. But what did you think when you heard that?
Well, I was sadly disappointed. You know, had we been up front, had BP been up front from day one, we could have been better prepared. We could have known this stuff was coming ashore. When we were told it wasn't coming ashore, we could have known what we were dealing with. And unfortunately, we're behind the eight ball here and trying to keep this stuff out of our marshlands. And it's a fight every day, and it's a battle that we're slowly losing.
What do you think of this transition to power to Bob Dudley, who's from Hattiesburg, as I mentioned? He's going to be sort of the new point person. It's unclear if this was expedited by Tony Hayward's participation in that yacht race, for which he was roundly criticized. But do you think it's time for someone else to sort of be in charge here?
Absolutely. You know, we knew we didn't have the right man just by the comments he made, the sense of urgency, and hopefully things will change in the next week or so. We've got to see some sense of urgency in getting this all picked up quickly.
I know that over the weekend, you and some of your crews, personal crews, I guess, or parish crews came out, and there was a stand down. There weren't any workers keeping the oil off out of the marshes or off the shoreline.
Right.
What was the explanation for that?
They told me yesterday that there was a meteorologist that said it was bad weather. Well, there's bad weather every day in South Louisiana. If you don't like the weather, wait 15 minutes, it'll change. But you've got to strategically be out there picking up the oil if bad weather sets in, and that's why we call for the jackup boats early on. You've got to have somewhere on the front line out there where they can take shelter away from lightning, but get right back to work. We're losing days, and we're losing this war by standing down because a meteorologist somewhere says, hey, it's bad weather.
Let me ask you a question that nobody seems to be able to answer. 17,500 National Guardsmen, Billy, as you know, were authorized, activated, and yet something like 6,500 have been utilized. It seems to me that that's a lot of manpower being put to waste. Why won't the governors call them up?
Well, you know, there's only so much you can do here. You've got to have vessels, you've got to have skimmers, vacuum equipment to get out there and get the oil.
But couldn't they be on the beach laying boom? Couldn't they be out in boats doing things?
Well, if we had the vessels, you know, what we've done with them, or what I've seen our governor do, is get out there and drop sandbags, put berms along the shoreline, which has caught a lot of the oil. We don't have a lot of beaches. The ones that are out there are being worked on now. The dredges are pumping, building those beaches, and when they're complete, we'll be able to put a lot more bodies out there to pick up that oil. But what we need is strategic teams in the marsh picking up this oil before the birds have a chance to dive in it and save a lot more wildlife. And we're just not managing it in small teams at this point. We really need that management level to be divided by certain areas and strike teams to respond immediately, not days, hours after the oil hits.
All right, Billy Nungesser, thanks so much. Always good to see you. Thanks, Billy.
A lot happens early on The Early Show, weekday mornings on CBS.